Hello everyone, I am Gyan and you are learning computer science with Python for class 11. In this video we are going to learn about if statements of Python. The if statements of Python. The if statement is a conditional statement in Python. If statement is used to select or not select various statements for execution. The selection happens based on condition. So you can write if statement as type the keyword if followed by conditional expression followed by a colon. You should write a colon here. The colon button is present on your keyboard on the right of L button. When you press the keyboard button, which is on the right of L button with shift, then you will able to type colon. So if conditional expression colon, if this conditional expression results in true, then you have to execute various statements. Notice here that these statements are written after certain indentation, generally a tab, means after writing the if condition, you have to press a tab and then you need to write all the statements which should execute if the condition is true. So here it is compulsory to press a tab. This is called indentation. The tab should be pressed for all the statements which comes under this condition. We will try this code practically. But before to that, let's assume a real programming problem. Suppose that a variable a is equal to 5, then you check if a is greater than 3. Then you have to write colon. After writing colon, give an indentation and write the statement like print a is greater than 5. And you can write few more statements here. Like print hello in the double quote. So this is one example of using if statement in Python. Let's use this statement in Python practically. Ideally, here right now, we are not going to write if statement in the Python cell. We are going to write it in the script mode. So open file, new file, and type your program here. Type here a is equal to 5, and then if a is greater than 3, give a colon, press enter, and here it is automatically taking the indentation. Because editor is like that. If you write the same code in notepad, then you must will have to press the tab button. But here in this case, since editor itself is giving an indentation, then I do not need to type a tab here. Okay. When I pressed enter after colon, my second control came here at this point. So type print a is greater than 5 and then print hello. Print hello. These two statements are going to execute only if a is greater than 3. If a is greater than 3, this relational operator, this relational operation results true, then only these two statements will execute. Otherwise not. So go to run module, and I think you first have to save this program. So press OK. And after that, just name it a.py or whatever the name you like. Press save. I want to replace it because I have a.py already present in the directory. So press here and it executes fine. It is giving result. Why? Because a is greater than 5. That's why. After the if statement, you can write some more code. Like you can write here print out of if out of if body. See, whatever the statements come under the if statement are called body of the if statement. And when the control finishes all the body of the if statement, it goes out of the if statement and prints the rest of the statements present in the program. Now again execute it, run module. Of course you need to save it, and it executes fine. After printing the body of the if, it prints out of if body. Now let's change the value of a and change it to 2. If a is equal to 2, then in this case a is not going to be greater than 3, means this relation operation will result false. If there is a false with if, then if body does not execute. So here the if body is not going to execute. Save the program by pressing Ctrl S. Here the if body will not execute, and only thing which gets printed after this program will be out of if body. Go to run module, and as you can see, out of if body has been printed, and the statements in the if body do not get chance for the execution because the if condition was not true. So hopefully you are getting the meaning of if statement. Therefore we can say that these two statements come under if body. If body, the indentation is not always necessarily a tab. Idea is that you should give a space in all the statements of the if body. Tab is not always necessary for indentation. Let's try it. Instead of writing here tab, if I just give one space to all the statements, then also it will work fine. But you just have to remember that all the statements in one if body should follow same amount of space, same amount of indentation. Now run module, and it executes fine. Let's change the value of a so that if body also gets executed. A is equal to 5, run module, and here you are. Only idea is that all the statements in the if body should follow the same indentation, should follow the same amount of spacing. Tab is not always necessary. The if condition is not always this simple. If condition can be complicated. For example, you can write if a is greater than 3 and a is less than 8. Now tell me what this expression will result. Let's try it in the Python cell. A is equal to 5. And then right here, a is greater than 3 and a is less than 8. A is greater than 3 is true, and a is less than 8 is also true. True and true is true, therefore this returns true. And I told that if the expression in the if condition results true, then the if body gets executed. Therefore, in this case, the if body will execute. Let's run module, and it executes fine. Now let's write something else. A is greater than 3 and a should be less than 4 or less than 5. A is greater than 3 is true, but a is less than 5 is not true. It is false. True and false is false. And as I told that, if the condition expression after if statement is false, then if body does not execute. So here the if body will not execute. Run module, and if body does not execute. It only executes the statement after the if body. So here you are going to use all your experience with the relational operators and logical operators. In the condition of the if block, you are going to write an expression which are having relational operations and logical operations. But in reality, we all know that true and false have some hidden meanings in Python We already have learned about the concept of true and false in the previous videos of this course. For example, if I write here true, then it is always going to be true. This is the true literal. This is not any expression which is going to be result in true. This is already true. And here, since if condition is true, therefore if body is going to be executed. Let's save it. Run module. And if body executes, because there was a true in if condition. Similarly, instead of true, if you write false, then here you just have used the literal false. If this is the case, then the if body is not going to be executed, because there is a false in the if condition and it will print only out of if body. Just save it. Run module, and it executes fine. If body does not get executed, and whatever the statement was present after the if body executes. Similarly, we know that there are very hidden meanings of true and false in Python. We already have learned about it in the previous videos of this course. We know that if we write anything, any number which is non-zero, then that means true. That means if I write here 78, it means true, because 78 is true. Therefore, in this case, the if body will execute, because 78 means true. Let's save it. Run module. And here you got the if body got executed. At the same time, if you write here 0, then if body will not execute, because 0 means false. Run module, and as you can see, if body is not executed. If you write a string which is having some content, say ABCD, then that string is supposed to be true, and when you run it, the if body is going to be executed. But at the same time, if this string is an empty string, it will be false, and if body will not execute. Run module, and if body does not execute, because empty string means false. The similar are the cases with the list or tuple. An empty list is considered as false, whereas a list with elements are considered as true. An empty tuple is considered as false, whereas the tuple with elements are considered as true. We already have learned about these definitions of true and false in the previous videos, and I think you are comfortable with this concept. Only one thing you should remember: if whatever you are writing after if results in true, then if body will execute, and whatever you are writing after if is false, then if body will not execute. The other thing we are going to learn in Python is if else statement. Look at what happens in if body. Suppose that you have a is equal to 5, and then you are writing if a is greater than 5, then do something, print a is greater than 5, and then you are printing something else out of if. Now, in this case, if a is greater than 5, then you will print that a is greater than 5. But suppose that if a is not greater than 5, then you want to print a is not greater than 5. Here in this case, you need to check two types of cases. If the if condition satisfies, then what you do? And if the if condition does not satisfy, then what you do? With the if statement, we have written a code for if the condition satisfies. That means if the condition returns true. But we do not have anything for if the condition is not true. Okay, we are not saying what we are going to do if the condition is not true. So to add a code which execute if the if condition is not true, you need to use the else statement. You need to use the else statement. Else print a is not greater than 5. What I mean here is, if a is greater than 5, then it will print a is greater than 5. But if a is not greater than 5, then this condition will result false. And whenever the condition with if results in false, then else body gets executed and it will print its own statement. So this one is the if body and this one is the else body. So let's try it practically. So I'm writing, if a is greater than 5, tell me if this condition will be true or not. No, this condition is not going to be true because a is equal to 5, not greater than 5. So if a is greater than 5, then you are going to print two statements. Whereas if a is not greater than 5, you need to do something else. That's why you write else. Let's give just one space as we have given it in if. But here you can also type tab. But inside the if or inside the else, all the statements should have same indentation. Okay, means these two indentations can be different in the if or else, but inside the if or inside the else, all the statements should have the same indentation. So write print a is not greater than 5 and then print hi. Can you tell me what output you expect? The else part will be executed because a is not greater than 5, so if part is not going to execute. And if this statement is false, it will print else part. Okay, so let's execute, run module, and here you got the output. A is not greater than 5, then high, and after that it prints out of if body. Therefore, we use else statement to execute if condition fails. Now let's tell me, if I write here 6, then which will execute, if part or else part? Of course, if body will execute. Else body is not going to execute if condition is true. So run module, and here in this case, if body gets executed, else body does not get executed. If you directly write here true, or you write here anything which implies true, okay, of course T should be capital in true, then in that case if body will execute and else will not execute. But if you directly write here the literal false, or you write here anything which implies false, then in that case if body will not execute but else will execute. Save it, run module, and as you can see, if body got executed because we have written true in the if condition. If I write false, then, and we run module, here we executed the else part. So this is the if else statement. Hopefully you are getting it. Now let's take a simple example. I am going to write a program which takes a number and checks if that number is even or odd. Program that takes a number and checks whether the given number is odd or even. I have written this problem as comment because, as you know, that comments are not interpreted by the Python interpreter. So this is the problem we have to solve. Therefore, let's start. Let's first take an input. Okay, num is equal to int, and inside the int we have to write input. All these concepts we have already discussed. Okay, inside the int write input and type enter an integer. If num% 2 is 0, and of course you should not write parenthesis here. I am very used to of C and Java. That's why I have written it. If num percent 2 is 0, why I am writing num modulo 2? If num modulo 2 is 0, why I am writing num modulo 2? Because if you remember that, modulo operation returns remainder. That means if I write 5 modulo 2 or 5% 2, it will return 1 remainder of 5 divided by 2. Okay. That's why we are using modulo operator. So if you divide a number by 2 and that division results in remainder 1, then in that case you can say that that number is odd. So if applying num modulo 2 results in 0, that means num is even, because when we have divided num by 2, we got 0 as the remainder, and that happens with the even number. Therefore print num is even number, num comma is even number. Otherwise, if num percent 2 is not equal to 0, in that case that num will be odd. Otherwise, that means else, what you have to print? You have to print whatever the number you have typed is odd. If you are not getting the syntax of print statement, or you are not getting the meaning of modulo operation, or you are not getting how we are taking input, then you really need to watch all the previous videos of this course. So we have written a program which detects if the number we input through the keyboard is an even number or odd number. Let's run it, run module, and just remember that this program is going to work only with integers, means whole numbers. So we will try only whole numbers as the input. Let me fresh start. Run module. Type here 5. It says 5 is odd. Again go on run module. Type here 788. It says 788 is even. So this is how we have written a program by using if and else. There are many other programs given in your book. So we will go through all these programs later when we come live and when we discuss the various programs and various questions asked in the Python programming courses. Okay, so these programs will be discussed when we come live, and we will discuss all these programs live. Here I am just including few programs for your understanding purpose. We will have a detailed discussion on these programs later. After if else statement, we have something called if elif statement. Okay, if elif statement. Now you may ask, what is if elif statement? Look at this program. What we have checked here, we have checked if a is greater than 5 or not. If a is greater than 5, then we had to print a is greater than 5. Otherwise, we had to print a is not greater than 5. Now I want to check three things: if a is greater than 5 or not, if a is equal to 5 or not, and if a is less than 5 or not. Getting it? Okay, I want to check three conditions, but with the if else only two conditions are possible: if condition of if is true, or if condition of if is false. Only two types of conditions are possible. So to include more than two conditions, we need if elif statement. Let's see how to use it. There is no such big changes. What you have to do here is, instead of writing here else, write elif. But when you write elif, you have to give a condition just like if. You have to write if a is double equals 5. So first I have checked if a is greater than 5 or not. Then I have checked if a is equal to 5 or not. If a is equal to 5, then you have to print a is equal to 5. Similarly, here you can have various elif with different conditions. But right now in our problem, we have scope for only one elif. Okay, but technically you can have various elif with different conditions. After writing all the elifs, at last, you may choose to write else. You may choose to write else. Okay. In this case, else will execute only if all the previous statements, all the previous condition checks are false. Then only else will execute. Here you can write print a is less than 5. Now see what will happen here. The first condition in the if statement will be checked. If that is true, then you are done. You are not going to check any of the elif, or you are not going to execute the else. But if the if condition is false, then first elif will be checked. If the first elif is true, then you are done. The rest of elifs will not execute, and else will also not execute. Even the conditions of rest of elifs will not be checked. But if the first elif is false, then the another elif will be checked. And if all the conditions in if or elif are false, then else will be executed in that case. Let's try it practically. Let's write if num is equal to 5, then print num is 5, elif, and the condition of elif, num is greater than 5, then you write, then you print num is greater than 5, num is greater than 5, and finally you have else. Okay, you write num is less than 5. Got it? So if you enter 5, then first condition will be matched and will return true, and other conditions are not going to be matched. But if you enter a number which is greater than 5, then first condition will not be matched, second condition will be matched, and you are going to print this statement. In this case also, else will not execute. But if you write a number which is less than 5, then first condition will not be matched, second condition will not be matched, therefore else has to execute in this case. After you come out the if statement and write print out of if elif ladder, we say it ladder. Now let's execute this code. Run module, type a number. I want to type say 6. And it prints 6 is greater than 5. Okay, followed by out of if elif ladder. So hopefully you are getting it. Now run it with a different input. Let's type here 4. 4 is not equal to 5, 4 is not greater than 5. So the else statement, the last else statement will execute and will print 4 is less than 5. Now let's see, whatever the input you are giving is marks of an student. Let me delete this program name. And you have to check in which category that marks belong to. If marks is less than 30, that means the student is failed. Okay, you write here a student failed. Okay, if the marks is greater than equal to 30 and greater than equal to 30 and marks less than 45, okay, marks less than 45, then in that case you should print third division. Here in this case you need to put more elif statements, so let's write another elif. If marks is greater than equal to 45, okay, but marks is less than 60, then what you write here? Write second division. Print second division. Further, If marks is greater than 60, marks is greater than equal to 60, and marks is less than 90, that means first division. Else, what the other condition remaining here? Distinction. So here you have used multiple elif in a given if else ladder. Okay, if marks is less than 30, you are going to print a student failed. But if the marks is not less than 30, then you are going to check another elif condition. If this condition satisfied, that means the marks is greater than or equal to 30 and the marks is less than 45, then you are going to print third division. If this condition also not gets satisfied, then you will be checking the next elif condition. And if this condition satisfied, then you are okay. You do not need to check anything else. But if this condition also does not get satisfied, then you are going to check the third elif condition. If all the conditions present in this ladder are wrong, then in that case, else will execute. Otherwise, if any one condition becomes true, then it will print the statement corresponding to that condition. Okay, so hopefully you are getting it. And you can have multiple statements inside if or inside elif or inside else. Here I have written only one statement, but you can have multiple statements inside if, inside elif or inside else. If you have multiple statements inside any of these, those statements should be equally indented. Now let's save it and let's run this code. Enter an integer, and I'm going to write here 46, and it prints second division, and finally it prints out of elif ladder. Here else is not compulsory. I can remove else and it will execute fine. Else means if none of the condition results true, then else body gets executed. But else is not compulsory here. Run module, and it will execute fine actually. You write here just 30 and it prints third division. But since the else is not present, run module, if you type here 95, then you do not have any statement to execute on the number 95. Earlier it was else. Else was for the execution of number which is greater than or equal to 90. But here, since there is no else, it is not going to be executed. Or we can put another elif here saying if marks is greater than equal to 90 and marks is less than equal to 100, then you write distinctions. Otherwise, you can write wrong marks entry. So you can improve your program like this. Wrong marks entry. Let's execute it. Run module. If I write here 95, it says distinction. Again, let's execute. Run module. If I write here 102, 101, it gets wrong marks entry. So you can apply various conditions and you can write your program. So we are not going to see all the programs which can be solved by using if and elif statements. There are multiple programs available. Go through your book, read those programs, and try to solve them by yourself. Try to understand them by yourself. And we will also discuss all these programs in the live sessions. After the if else ladder, the next thing we are going to learn is nested if statement. What do you mean by nested if statement? If inside a if body or inside a else body or inside a elif body, you have another if else body, then this situation is called nested if statement. What I mean here is, suppose that you have a if statement followed by certain condition, conditional expression, And after that, you have elif. With this elif, you again have certain conditional statement, conditional expression. Of course, both need to end with a colon. And then after you have else. In the else, again you have some statements like S3, S4. Here you have S1, S2. So you have multiple statements in elif, you have multiple statements in else. And inside the if body, actually you have another if else. So inside the if body, instead of normal statements, you are going to have another if else, conditional expression. And here you have the statement S5, statement S6. After that you can have else. In the else you have a statement 7, something like that. So if else or a complete if else ladder can present inside another if block, can present inside another elif block, or can present inside another else block. So this if else can be present in the if body, or can be present in the elif body, or can be present in the else body. This is called nested if else. One if else inside another if else, called nested if statement. Nested if statement. Let's write a practical program to demonstrate use of a nested if else. Write a program that reads three numbers, three integers, and prints them in ascending order. Prints them in ascending order. Okay, hopefully you are getting it, that what actually you have to do. So first, let's take three integers as input. X is equal to input, enter first number, and this input should be of type integer. Hopefully you know all these concepts. After that, we have to take second number as the input. Take second number as the input and store it in Y. And third, take third number as the input and store it in the variable Z. Now we have to check which number is the smallest one. Let's check if X is less than other two numbers or not. Okay, if X is less than Y and X is less than Z, if X is less than other two numbers or not. Suppose that X is the smallest one. Okay, X is less than both the numbers Y and Z, because this condition is going to be satisfied only if X is the smallest one. But now X is proven to be smallest one, but now you have to compare Y and Z. So check which of these two numbers Y or Z is smaller. So if Y is less than Z, then what you have to do, take three variables and assign them in an order. Okay, let's write mean 1, because mean has a separate meaning here. Okay, so let's write mean 1, comma, mid, comma, max. Mean means minimum, mid means middle, and max means maximum. Max again has a separate meaning, so write here 1. And if I'm writing 1 after mean and max, so let's write 1 after mid also. Okay, so mean, mid, max. Which one is the minimum? Tell me. X is the minimum in this case. Which one is the middle? Y is the middle. And which one is the maximum? Z is the maximum. Otherwise, what you have to do is, you have to change the order, mean, mid, max. Now, suppose that if Y is not less than Z, then of course Z is less than or equal to Y. So in that case, what you are going to do is, again we are going to assign mean 1, mid 1, and max 1. But here is equal to, of course X is minimum in this case also, but Z is the middle. and y is the maximum. Now let's check another step. This is the case when x was the minimum. Now let's see a case when not x but y is the minimum. If y is less than x and y is less than z. So here in this case y is minimum, and now comparison is between x and z. So in this case minimum is going to be y, because y is minimum. Next is going to be x, and third one is going to be z. Again minimum is going to be y, and next is going to be z, and third one is going to be x. Hopefully you are getting it. Let's see the third condition. The third condition where z is minimum. So type z is less than x and z is less than y. Now the comparison is between x and y. If x is less than y, in that case x is mid one, means x is the middle number. Of course z is going to be minimum because it has proven to be minimum, but the middle one is x and the maximum one is y. Again here z is going to be minimum, the middle one is y and the maximum is x, because if y is less than x, then of course y will be the middle one. What we are doing in these three cases is, first we are checking who is the minimum. So here if x is the minimum, means x is smaller than y and z both, then the competition is between y and z. That's why inside the if body we are comparing y and z. If y is the second minimum, then y is going to be middle one, because y is greater than x but less than z. And if this condition does not hold true, that means z is less than y, and here z is going to be in middle, because z is greater than x but less than y. So after finding a perfect mean one, mid one and max one, we have to print them. So let's print the values of mean one, mid one and max one in a given order. Save it, run module, enter the first number 5, then enter 4, then enter 6, and you have 4, 5, 6. If you run again, at this time enter 6, 5, 4, you have again 4, 5, 6. So you are always going to print numbers in the ascending order. So here you are effectively using nested if else. You should try multiple programs given in your book. There is no limit of practice in any programming language. Just keep on practicing on various programs given in your book. Next we are going to learn is storing the conditions. Storing the conditions in a variable. Storing conditions. What do you mean by storing a condition? Suppose that if I am writing, if a is less than 2 and a is greater than minus 5. You know that this is an expression which results either in true or false. Okay. So instead of writing this big condition, if I store it in a variable, say con1 is equal to a less than 2 and a greater than minus 5. If you do it, and instead of writing this big expression, if I just write if con1, then I am saved from typing this statement again and again. So if in your code there is a long conditional expression which repeatedly used in your code, then you can store the result of complete expression in a variable. And instead of using that expression, you can use the variable. This is called storing the condition. For example, here in this case, instead of writing x less than z and x less than y, I can create a variable a which stores x less than 5 and x less than z. So this is the first variable, Second variable is B, which is y is less than x and y is less than z. Okay, and third one is the third variable C, which is z is less than x and z is less than y. So instead of writing this big one, you can write just A, because whatever the result of this expression is now stored in A. Instead of writing this big one, you can write B. Instead of writing this big one, you can write C. So let's save it, run module. Let's input the first number. The first number is 5, second number is 4, the third number is 6, and here it is 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so the program is working as it was working before. Only difference is that we have stored the result of various conditional expressions in various variables. This is the only difference we have. So till now, we have used if and else in the script mode of Python. You may ask, how to use if else in a Python cell? For that, you just type if 2 is less than 3, give a colon, and when you press enter, the Python command prompt, means this sign, triple greater than sign, does not appear again. Okay, and here you type your body, like print hi. When you press enter, the Python command prompt does not appear again, and you type print hello. After that, again you press enter, the Python command prompt does not appear again, but at this time you are end up with your if body. So what you have to do, you just press the enter again, and here it gets executed. Since 2 is less than 3, therefore hi and hello got printed. So hopefully now you are comfortable using if else and conditional statements in Python. You know about the if statement, you know about the else statement, you know about elif statement. See you in the next video, where we will learn about range function in Python. See you in the next video.